So much like I said last episode, this is probably the last final episode. There's nothing left in the game. I completed everything. I synthesized everything. I beat all the bosses. This is it. I completed Jiminy's journal. I got like 4 achievements in 1 fight. And this is the end. Oh, look where we are. Amazing. We're in Destiny Island.
Is this my island?
I mean, sure. Oh, I can't. Can I not go? Nope, that's not. That's an invisible wall now. That sucks. Well, time to go in that hole that. Oh, the river's gone. Waterfall's gone.
This world has been connected.
Has it?
What was that?
How
was that invisible wall disappearing?
Soon to be completely eclipsed. There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
I mean, I understand so little because this game explains so little.
One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
Man, it's Rock. It's Roxas. It's Riku. Remember that guy? Man, I haven't seen Riku in such a long time. Hey, Riku, time to fight
Riku,
you again, probably.
Look at this tiny place.
Oh, it's not Riku. It's
Sansa. To the heart-seeking freedom, this island is a prison, surrounded by water. And so this boy sought out to escape from his prison. He sought a way to cross over into other worlds, and he opened his heart to darkness.
Riku!
Don't bother. Your voice can no longer reach him where he is. His heart belongs again to darkness. All worlds begin in darkness. And all so end. The heart is no different. Darkness sprouts within it. It grows, consumes it. Such is its nature. In the end, every heart returns to the darkness whence it came. You see, darkness is the heart's true essence.
That's not true! The heart may be weak, and sometimes it may even give in. But I've learned that deep down there's a light that never goes out.
Good. Light, darkness, friendship.
So you have come this far, and still you understand nothing. Every light
That's
must
Sora.
Fade. Every heart return to darkness!
I'm gonna go fight Anson.
Come on!
This dude's just gonna melt.
Come Guardian!
Come Guardian. Oh, the game. What's this game trying to pull off that thing behind it?
Come Guardian!
I mean, I don't even need Hera. This thing is. This guy. This is the most
I'm Guardian.
I'm so many levels higher than this guy. Again, you can beat this guy like.
Come on!
I'm Guardian!
He's just melting! I know I'm level 100, I have the ultimate Keyblade, I have like.
So
many! 75 attacks. Oh, this is like a healing
beam. Come on, open your heart.
Come on!
Open your heart to darkness. How about you open your heart to your dying?
Come on! Heal!
Yeah, don't attack him anymore, he's dead. And that's so he ends the game. Nah, I'm just kidding. You gotta fight him like 6 more times. So also, one thing about Anson, he's the only sentient Heartless in the entire series. No other Heartless in the game is sentient. He's the only one. Makes no sense whatsoever. The closest would be Scar from Kingdom Hearts 2, but he doesn't ever talk. Heartless. You know, I never realized this place is for the kids. They built this entire area for themselves, I guess. With all these tree houses, whatever. So I guess this one will be a little bit harder because now it's just first sense. It's the same. Oh no, it's Darkseid. Gotta fight Darkseid again. Remember this stupid thing? That I fought already twice in the game? Man, can't wait to fight this guy. Oh man. Boss. I forgot he could. Sure, this is like a warrior of sword or something stupid like that. What I just did there. Can it come down? Right in your arm, buddy. And these fights. Dance him again. What was the point of fighting Darkseid there? I don't know. I don't know. He actually has health knockers. Oh, so man. He didn't get me though.
Come on!
Take this!
Heal! Win!
I'll put a shield on this one.
Come Guardian!
Make sure your attack where you go, you put on the ground. There's something, buddy. Oh, no, he hit me.
Open your heart. Open your heart.
Every so often, I'm
gonna open your heart.
Stop me in there. You know, you actually made yourself weaker by not having your shield guy.
My strength returns. What do you hope to accomplish? The final darkness is
Submit!
Open your heart. Come, open your heart. Open your heart.
Heal.
Come, open your heart.
Come on. Win.
Submit. My strength returns.
Oh man, he gets one of them left.
What do you hope to accomplish?
Probably your death.
Final darkness.
There's no death. No one really dies. Kill a person like 30 times, come back. Well, that's like a plot line in the game. You can kill people and they just come back to life eventually. Oh no, we're in a world darkness. How on earth did we get here?
Behold the endless abyss.
Man, what a filter.
Within it lies the heart of all worlds.
Kingdom Hearts.
Look as hard as you are able. You'll not find even the smallest glimmer of light. From those dark depths are all hearts born. Even yours.
Great. Man, imagine if
darkness conquers all worlds!
Change control. weird boss thing that we're fighting. It's a parts spaceship thing. Oh, they got absorbed into the ship.
Giving up already? Come on, Sora. I thought you were stronger than that.
It's so blurry. Why does it be so blurry when it does that? At least don't make the words blurry. Oh, man. We can actually fly in this world. I gotta fight
Come on! Turn to darkness! Welcome the darkness into you. Turn to darkness!
This is the final boss.
All shall be
stopped. Can't even move your mouth.
Still come on, lost. Then perhaps this will be light.
What do you need, magic?
Welcome to darkness. All shall be extinct.
All shall be extinct, huh? Oh, he gets absorbed. Oh, he's a crest now. I gotta go into that vortex. Quite a bunch of heartless. That actually have more health than the ones in the later, than the other worlds. They're dropping me. That's hilarious.
Come on!
I'm not used to a shadow actually surviving. Something. Blew something up. Pretty sure none of these enemies in this area are part of the journal. Yeah, they're not part of the journal. You already had finished the journal. You finished all the entries. These weird. Whatever these things are supposed to be. They don't have the heartless symbol. I was doing that for fun. Well, time to go into another one. Portal of Darkness knocked me out of it. I'd like to go in the Portal of Darkness, please. Oh, dude, who came was here? What you just did? Heal me? I wasn't paying attention. These guys are so great. Glad they're not the other Kingdom Hearts besides. They're all so dripping negative stuff. Not sure when I'd ever be able to equip these items. Oh man, it's a heart, maybe? Heartless heart. Whatever, I just blew it apart. He got messed up in that world. We are like halfway. There's like two fights left, and then the game ends. I am not even kidding. We gotta fight the face now. Oh, it's got a lot of health.
Come on!
Fight the ship now. Oh, it's got the laser beams.
This should help.
That's right. forward on. I don't think the face actually does anything. Oh, it did something. It was a little bit too late.
Come on!
Bye, sir. Heal! 3,000 experience? Really?
Come on!
Exactly, worth the same amount of experience.
Oh, don't give up!
Don't give up. And then we got Goofy. Oh, it's pretty hard to see them. They're very gotta blow up myself. We're gonna get two episodes of me fighting stuff with the ultimate weapon. And Face is gone. Goodbye, Face. I'm really messing your stuff up there, Ansem. I'm gonna go grab this guy and beat up his gut. His evil demon gut. Wildly was inconvenient. I don't think I've ever killed all these things. Oh, they're all dead. You guys take those things out. I'll take out this weak link. I've got them all. Damn. Kill the guy. Cut him in half. The Ansem got him dead. Oh no, Ansem's back. Man, that would have been really impressive if we already didn't fight that thing already in the beginning. Now it's gonna be even easier because we have three
Dark!
That was so much.
Heal! Defense!
Cut it.
Come on!
Are you attacking now? Yeah.
Your
real power. Your real power is ignoring the goat and making you laugh. You're running away from him.
Welcome to darkness.
Come on!
Is this the answer?
Yeah, I killed you and your stupid giant spaceship thing that you for some reason. Oh man. Surprise, surprise. It wasn't very strong. Then he exploded. That's it. I mean, I literally can't play anymore. It's all the rest of this game is cutscenes. Kingdom Hearts.
The Keyblade alone cannot seal the door to darkness.
Why did you turn back
Kingdom
into a person instead of a ship?
Fill me with the power of darkness.
Okay, I'll fill you with something.
Supreme Darkness!
You're wrong. I know now, without a doubt. Kingdom Hearts is light!
Oh no, it was so wrong.
All his research did nothing.
Light.
All he had to do was talk to Kairi's grandmother. He would have not died.
But why?
And then Anson dies again. Man, I imagine if this character came back like 3 or 4 times in the next couple games. That'd be crazy, right?
Come on!
And there was multiple versions of him. And his name wasn't Ansem. It was something else. And he named himself Ansem. Man, that'd be so crazy if that's how the plot went. Whoa. His name was actually Xehanort or something stupid like that. It's the Heartless World. It's the Heartless, and they're behind the door for some reason.
Don't give up! Come on, Sora!
And Riku's
together
there, too,
do it.
For some reason.
Okay.
So, if Kingdom Hearts is light, why is the world of Heartless behind it? Doesn't he grab the handles? Oh, man. It's Darkseid. Multiple dark sides. That would have probably been a lot harder to fight two of them at the same time. Oh, no, they're not dead. My god, it's Mickey Mouse. And he's got no shirt, which is actually a plot point in later games. No, seriously, it's a plot point. I am not kidding you. I wish I was. It is a plot point.
There will always be a door to the light.
Sora, you can trust King Mickey.
Now, they're coming.
Donald?
What's coming?
Goofy, thank you.
Mickey Mouse had one scene the entire game. That gave them the strength
to
close the
door
themselves. I'll lose her continuously and then die in the third game trying to save her. And then I'll forget all about her in the Enchanted Mountain. That's how the plot goes. Imagine if you could steal Kingdom Hearts. Also, make me have her now. Somehow, sealing Kingdom Hearts brings all the worlds back together. How's that work? Who knows. Oh! Riku laughing? This is a dream. No, Riku! Kairi's actually there. I don't remember that cutscene. This is the end of the game. Yeah, what's up? The snake in the cellar? I'm upstairs. There's a snake in the cellar? What? Okay.
Kairi!
Okay, so apparently there's a snake in my cellar. I'm gonna let this cutscene play while I'm trying to
investigate
the snake.
Remember what you said before? I'm always with you too. I'll come back to you. Yeah. I promise. I know you will.
Give
So, I mean, I didn't actually see it, but they took a picture of it. It looked like a garden. Like I said before, a long time ago, this is my favorite. As much as I'll make fun of it. But I'm mostly making fun of the fact that this game is basically ignored after this. Anything this game says, you are chosen. This Keyblade chose you. Just about every character in the game later on have a Keyblade. Like, there's like 12 characters that Keyblades. They made prequels to this game where there's like multiple characters that have Keyblades in the game to play it. So to me, that's kind of stupid. The Keyblade was supposed to be something so precious and so special. Why did it make every single character happen? Oh, also, to get Kyurga, you had to talk to Ares like 3 times inside the... inside of Hollow Bastion. Which, in 2, they renamed it Radiant Garden for some reason. Not sure why they keep renaming everything in 2. Like, they renamed so many different things in 2. Like, the main antagonist, they renamed him. Like, I could see if the character was, like, secretly a Disney character. Like, oh my god, it was actually this character the whole time. But they made the character up again. Why would you make... Like, they make up a character like Anson. They make the whole game about this character. Like, oh my god, this guy was so cool and he did all this stuff. And then at the end of the game, it's like, oh my god, he was the villain the whole time. My god. And then the next one, they go, well, that wasn't actually Anson. That was Anson's apprentice, Xehanort. And Xehanort took his name for some reason. And then his nobody took his name. Because his nobody's name is Xemnas, which is Ansem backwards with an X in it. Oh yeah, then we got these little cutscenes of characters. My god, that's blurry. What is that, PlayStation 2 graphics? What happened here? Did they not, like, update this part of the game? Like, that's really bad looking. But either way, I finally beat that. Yeah, they did not redo this part here. Oh, this is really weird that they would not do this part. Oh, Cloud going with Ares, that's funny. Yeah, Tifa's in the second game. Pinocchio, never gonna see him again. His plot line is over. He became a real boy, and now his games are over. Honestly, a lot of the summons from this one have worlds in the second game. Like Simba. Dumbo's pretty much dead. Simba, Mushu has his worlds in that. Don't get me wrong, 2 is okay. I just despise the organization. The Organization 13. They're just not good characters. They're just boring. And it's kind of the reason I don't really care about Kingdom Hearts 2 as much as I do with the first one. The first one just has such, you know, it's a great game. Get all these Disney villains teaming up together. You gotta fight them. That's a really cool premise. And then the later games, the Disney characters, Disney villains, are just side things. They barely have anything to do with the plot. Like in 3, none of the Disney worlds really matter. None. Oh, Billy Zane. None of them matter. But they try to make it seem like, oh my god, Sora's doing this thing this whole game. It's like, no, he just gets to one plot point. He just, oh, I just have the ability to go power of waking again. I know I'm spouting out nonsense. But this is plot points from the later games that are utter nonsense. Also, these credits are just way too long. Skip the credits. That would probably would have been for the best. Again, I think the sad part about this is, would I play Kingdom Hearts 2? I don't know. It's a long game. I don't know if it's long. It's probably longer than this one because of how slow, the way the game's set up, but. I will say one thing about Kingdom Hearts 2, that's the combat is much, it's very smooth, very fast, very smooth combat. I hate the magic system, absolutely hate it. It's the magic system they use for the rest of the series, but that's about it. The combat's just really good. They make a bunch of new heartless and stuff. You get to go to Lion King's world, all kinds of good stuff like that. The problem is you gotta fight the organization the whole game. There's only one super boss in the game. There's some parts of that game that are so bad. You gotta block. The final boss in the game, he shoots like 100 laser beams at you. You gotta block them all, and if you don't, you just take so much damage. Now imagine if they played the entire game looking like their normal selves. If Donald and Goofy looked like that the whole game. It would've been so much better. We wait for
We've
Castle
find Riku
Oblivion.
And King Mickey.
No, they'll find their way out themselves.
Where do we start looking for that there door to the light?
No one cares.
Huh?
It's Pluto. For the plot point.
Hey, Pluto. Where have you been?
Huh?
Gosh, that's the king's seal.
Hey, have you seen King Mickey?
Nope.
Guys, let's go.
So hopeful. The next game is Chain of Memories. So all hope is lost. Would I ever play Chain of Memories? That's another lots of funny joke. The answer is no. There is no god on this earth that could ever get me to play Chain of Memories again. That game is just so awful. Remember, Sora, you are the one who opened the door to light. I guess. Ah, special secrets, another side, another story. This is kinda Kingdom Hearts 2. Some of this stuff is in it. Like these Neo buttons, whatever they're called. Neo Lord of Shadows. They're being beat apart into a little bit. There's Rocks. I'm sorry, there's Riku. Heartless symbol. Where's Sora? Your light, endless. I think this is a cutscene you get for completing like all the different side stuff in the game. Getting the 100 Dalmatians, sealing all the worlds. Source of Heartless? Like that'll ever be a plot in the game. Like, nope, that's not even how Kairi looks. Not at all. The end. I forget if this is one of those games where it actually doesn't let you. Yeah, oh no, never mind. I thought it was like Paper Mario games where the credits will just keep rolling over and over and over. Well, anyway, that's the end of Kingdom Hearts 1. Final mix. I never beat the final mix before. There wasn't a lot added into the game. Maybe a couple cutscenes and like one super boss. A couple enemies that I never really showed. But most of them were just really stupid or really hard to find. But they had these weird mechanics you had to do to fight them, get items from them. But there's this one ghost enemy that's inside of the area where you fight the parasite cage, the stomach. You have to use healing items to hurt it, because it's a ghost. And if you do that, it'll give you a stone. So you would just use elixirs and you get a stone every time. There's other hard, there's worse ones. Some of the synthesizing items were just... Ugh. That's nothing I want to ever do again. I don't have to think I showed the beginning, the intro. Thinking of you wherever you are. This is actually a plot point in the second game. This right here. Pray for our sorrowed end and hope that our hearts will blend. And I will step forward and realize this wish. This is something that you get at the very end of Kingdom Hearts 2. Who knows? Starting a new journey may not be as hard, or maybe it has already begun. There are many worlds, but they share the same sky. It's one sky, one destiny. I think Simple and Clean is not really in the rest of the series very much. Like, it might be in a couple of the side games that have no real identity other than pointlessness, but like 2 and 3 I know for sure have their own theme songs. Like Sanctuary and whatever the third one is. The third one's awful. Oh, it's Riku. It's just kind of like a... I'm just gonna let this play, and then this will be the end of Kingdom Hearts 1. Which is good, because I finished Kingdom Hearts 1 before Resident Evil 3 comes out, which is a game that I'm definitely gonna play. I don't know if all the episodes will be out before Resident Evil 3 comes out, but I definitely will be putting out Resident Evil 3 episodes before when it comes out. Immediately. I think this is gonna have like 42 episodes altogether. I mean, most of the later ones are like 10 minutes long, except for like the last episode, which is this one. Maybe like 30 minutes long. It's how short Anson's fight was. Ah, Oogie Boogie's place. It doesn't exist anymore. don't get to Peter Pan's level for such a long time, too. Hey, Bambi. Bambi was kind of useful in getting the items. I thought more useful, but he wasn't too useful. God, I remember that clock. The worst boss in the game. Stupid Bambi. I think there's an achievement for beating this game if, never changing your equipment. Never changing your equipment. And always just using the Kingdom Key, using whatever Donald and Goofy start with. And that sounds like the stupidest, the worst achievement ever. Playing this entire game without ever changing equipment. Like, you couldn't do anything. You couldn't fight any of the super bosses. How would you ever beat any of the super bosses with the Kingdom Key? How would you beat Sephiroth with just the Kingdom Key? But I've rambled on long enough. This episode has gone on way longer than it should have. So I'm going to end it here, and maybe one day I'll play Kingdom Hearts 2. That's about it. It's a big maybe. But I have the option.